Hi, welcome to another video. So you saw previously I set up the change notice on this PIC32 microcontroller, set up an interrupt and got it so as to every time I hit the screen it changes colours. I put a small delay in there, it looks like it's not long enough, but I wanted to show you how to use the switch case function. So in case some of you have got these TFTs with the XPT2046 touchscreen controller, thought I'll show you how I've wired mine up. So for those of you with the 5 and 7 inch TFTs with this XPT2046 touchscreen controller, you'll see in the circuit drawing it's already pulled high, and all I've done, so this is the interrupt, as soon as the screen, which is actually already wired up, as soon as this screen sees a touch, this interrupt goes low. So all I've done is use that interrupt, run it to B4, port B4, as you saw in the previous video on interrupts, and that's what I'm using. So it doesn't have to be a touchscreen, you could put a button here or signals from something, and all I'm doing is every time this goes low, the obviously change notice interrupts the microcontroller, generates an interrupt, and I start counting the interrupts. Well, you can see here I've got a char, so 0 to 255, 256 touchscreen counter, and it starts at 0 when the program first starts up, and then unsigned int for color. I called it color 1 because I've got color used somewhere else. This is the interrupt you saw the other day, so I don't need to go through that. You look at my previous video on change notice. I've got a small 35 millisecond delay, so when I touch the screen it will stop it bouncing and stop it seeing more than one touch. So 35 millisecond delay, then I'm clearing the interrupt flag so it's ready to see another touch, disabling my UART interrupts, and this is the switch case. So this switch, it's looking at my touchscreen counter, remembering it starts at 0, it can run up to 256, if you change it to an int it can run up to 65,000. So you see I've got the switch function and then case. So all it's looking at is what number the touchscreen counter has run up to, looks down this list, and if it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 to 13 for example, gives me that colour. So colour 1, CL red, blue, green, so on and so forth. Down the bottom, you don't have to have the microelectronica's defined colours, you can put in your own hexadecimal code there. So this is sort of like a pinky purple. And then so it looks at these 13 cases, depending on what the touchscreen counter got up to, gives me the relevant colour, and then at the end it changes the screen colour here. So this default, if it doesn't see one of these, if there's an error, the case isn't 1 to 13, it's good practice to put in a default. So my default colour is purple. And you see I'll demonstrate, it does actually run to purple, because if I scroll down, I'm re-enabling the interrupts. If the touchscreen counter is greater than 13, the touchscreen counter goes to 0. And you'll see there, my case is starting at 1, so I haven't got a 0. So at one point, it's going to go over 13, it's going to go to 0, there isn't a 0, so the default colour is going to be purple. And then at the end, touchscreen counter, plus plus. And for the beginners of you out there, plus plus is touchscreen counter equals the touchscreen counter plus 1. So every time it gets to this interrupt, it's going to keep on adding 1. Right, so red is case 1, case 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 is that made up colour, B048, so 14, so this is where the counter or the case goes to 0, and I haven't got 0 in there, so there's an error, so it just gives me purple, and then back to 1. So simple demonstration on how to use the case and switch function. Thank you very much.